tonight. A Spokane lawmaker is facing backlash for cursing out a local journalist in a voicemail. Jenny Graham represents the state's 6th district, which covers most of Spokane and west to the county line. She was caught on tape screaming profanity at an Inlander reporter and even making a veiled threat. Let's get to Mayor Kawash, who can tell us what caused Graham to leave a voicemail like that, Mayor.
Yeah, Aaron, I reached out to Jenny Graham and her office to get that answer, but we never got a call back today. Now, reporter Daniel Walters tells me he and Graham had a respectful relationship leading up to that voicemail, which came at the end of last month. He says an article he wrote that day about some of her internet posts is what apparently pushed her over the edge, and she had quite a mouthful to say.
Daniel, you lying piece of... You've done it. You have started it. Don't you ever call me again.
Those are the words Jenny Graham left on a reporter's voicemail on August 27th.
It's on. If you think for 1 minute that you're going to pull this crap and you're going to walk away from it, you're nuts.
In that article, Daniel Walters points out some links Graham shared on her YouTube and Facebook pages, links and articles which led to conspiracy theories from QAnon. In the article, Walters writes, Graham was unfamiliar with the conspiracy theory and unaware of the fringe views on these sites. Graham then left the outraged voicemail.
You lying piece of...
Which left Walters wondering what he did wrong.
If a source is really angry at you and is really upset about a story, the goal of a journalist is to figure out why.
Walters said he tried doing just that, following up with Graham to straighten things out. He hasn't heard from her since. He's also gone back to see if anything may be incorrect.
Everything in the story is connected to the audio recording of the interview or the screenshots of the Facebook post that she's made.
Walters says the Republican House leader J.T. Wilcox has reached out to him to apologize for Graham's use of words. Meanwhile, Graham's opponent in the upcoming election is calling on the Republican caucus to condemn her.
This type of language is something that we wouldn't allow a teacher to say, we wouldn't allow a mail carrier to say. They lose their jobs.
Now, again, we did reach out to Graham's office several times today, but never heard back. The Inlander has posted the full 78-minute interview with Graham, and we have a link to that on KXOY.com right now. Aaron?